Germany's genius new battery is powered by rust. Imagine the lights across Germany staying on for a week straight. No coal, no gas, no lithium, just iron, salt, and the air we breathe. Sounds like something straight out of a sci-fi novel, doesn't it? Well, engineers in Jülich just proved it's not only real, but it's happening. And the secret ingredient? It's the same red-brown stuff we absolutely hate seeing on an old bike. Rust. A single battery, roughly the size of a shipping container, can stash away solar power when the sun's blazing, and then give it back for more than 25 years. No cobalt, no nickel, no eye-watering price tag. Are you ready to see how a pile of junkyard iron could actually outsmart the best lithium farms on Earth? Let's dig in. Look, wind and solar are now the cheapest electrons on the planet, hands down. But here's the rub, they show up whenever they feel like it, not when we necessarily need them. A week of gray, still skies, what Germans aptly call Dunkelflaut, or a dark lull, can send wind and solar output plummeting to almost nothing. When that happens, grid operators scramble, gas plants fire up, electricity prices spike, and all our hard-won carbon goals go backwards. Lithium-ion batteries, bless their hearts, can bridge a few hours, maybe half a day if you're lucky. But try scaling that to weeks, and the price tag becomes absolutely jaw-dropping. We desperately need something that can just sit there for days, weeks, even months, storing gigawatt hours without degrading or, you know, catching fire. And it absolutely has to be built from stuff we can find anywhere on Earth. That's exactly the monumental challenge the German teams decided to tackle. At Forschungszentrum Jülich, researchers made a bold move. They ditched lithium entirely. Their innovative cell uses three incredibly common ingredients you can pretty much order in bulk today: iron powder, salt water rich in sodium ions, and a special membrane that breathes oxygen right from the ambient air. How does it work? During discharge, iron gives up electrons, combines with oxygen, and turns into, you guessed it, rust. When you flip the current, the reaction reverses, metallic iron reappears, and the cell is ready for another cycle. It's an elegant, almost poetic energy loop powered by rust, salt, and air. A key innovation here is a ceramic separator, only a few micrometers thick, that allows oxygen in but blocks corrosive nasties. This ingenious design ensures the electrodes survive tens of thousands of cycles. Lab data is seriously impressive, showing less than 2% capacity fade after 10,000 hours, which translates to a calendar life north of 25 years under real-world duty. And here's the bonus. Iron costs about $1 a kilo. Sodium hydroxide is cheaper than laundry detergent, and nobody is going to set an air-breathing battery on fire. This breakthrough eliminates reliance on critical minerals like lithium and cobalt, addressing major supply chain and ethical concerns that plague traditional batteries. So how big can this get? One shoebox-sized module stores about 10 kilowatt hours. String 1,000 of those together into a 40-foot shipping container, and you're looking at 10 megawatt hours. Now string 100 of those containers together, and you have a gigawatt hour. That's enough to back up a medium-sized city for an entire day. Because the chemistry behind this battery is exothermic, the battery banks gently warm themselves to about 60 degrees Celsius. This natural warmth eliminates the need for power-hungry cooling fans, simplifying the system and cutting down on auxiliary energy use. Round-trip efficiency sits around 50%, which, yes, is lower than lithium. But when your raw materials cost 90% less, that efficiency becomes a secondary worry. The target market here isn't seconds of power delivery, it's week-long storage. For that particular use case, cost per stored kilowatt hour is absolutely king. Meanwhile, another incredible German-backed innovation is taking shape. Augwind Energy, an Israeli company, is pairing up with German utility partners to stash renewable power underground, literally. This isn't a chemical battery, it's a mechanical marvel. Surplus wind or solar energy drives giant compressors that cram air into airtight salt caverns, thousands of meters below the surface. When power is needed, a valve opens, the compressed air rushes up, drives turbines, and generates electricity again. Think of it like a giant geological lung for the grid. One cavern, the size of a cathedral, can hold an astonishing 3 to 8 gigawatt hours of energy, enough to cover seasonal lulls. The round-trip efficiency tops 60% in commercial installations, and these caverns can cycle for more than 40 years with virtually no capacity fade. Germany is uniquely positioned for this, already boasting over 400 suitable salt domes across the country. This system is specifically designed to address those dreaded Dunkelflaute periods, storing energy for months at a time. While not as fast as lithium-ion for instantaneous response, its long-duration capability makes it a perfect complement for grid stability when paired with shorter-duration storage. Let's talk money. Lithium-ion grid packs today average about $130 per kilowatt-hour of storage. The Jülich team projects their iron cells will hit $20 per kilowatt-hour once produced at scale, representing an order of magnitude drop in cost. Now, factor in that 25-year life, and the price collapses even further on a per-cycle basis. For a utility company, that math is simply irresistible. Build an iron air yard right next to a wind farm, amortize it over decades, and you can store electricity for roughly 1 cent per kilowatt hour per cycle. Try beating that with any mainstream battery chemistry out there. Okay, so where's the catch? Nothing's perfect, right? Well, power density is modest. You wouldn't strap this to a Tesla. A 1 megawatt iron air container has about the footprint of a tennis court. Charging and discharging can take 8 to 12 hours, so forget millisecond grid stabilization. Efficiency is lower than lithium, meaning more energy is lost as heat. Finally, the supply chain for those ceramic oxygen membranes is still a bit boutique, so scaling to gigawatt factories will definitely take some time. Yet, for the grid, those drawbacks are perfectly acceptable. No one needs a Formula One battery to keep refrigerators humming through a cloudy fortnight. These batteries are designed for endurance, not speed, and for grid-scale applications, that's exactly what's needed. The German government isn't just talking, they're investing. Government-backed pilot projects are already under construction in North Rhine-Westphalia and Brandenburg. The first 10-megawatt demonstrator is scheduled to plug into the grid by 2026, storing excess solar in summer and feeding it back during those calm gray winter weeks. If these pilots hit their cost targets, utility giants RWE and EnBW have options to roll out a further 2 gigawatts by 2030. Across the Atlantic, Form Energy is building a similar iron air plant in West Virginia, so the race is on globally. But Germany holds the chemistry patent portfolio and, crucially, the salt cavern real estate. This powerful combo could slash the country's lithium imports by 40%, significantly strengthen energy security, and even create a brand new export industry. And it's not just rich countries that will benefit. An iron air battery can be assembled in a mid-sized factory, shipped in standard containers, and installed with local labor. Countries across Africa and South Asia could leapfrog the lithium age entirely, banking solar power for hospitals and factories without importing cobalt from conflict zones or dealing with complex, expensive supply chains. Because iron and salt are ubiquitous, geopolitical choke points simply disappear. Analysts at Bloomberg NEF estimate that if long-duration storage drops below $30 per kilowatt hour, renewables plus storage could undercut gas peakers in every major market by 2032. That, my friends, is a trillion-dollar tipping point just waiting to happen. If you're as stunned as I am that Rust might actually save the grid, then please smash that like button so the algorithm shows this to more engineering nerds. Drop a comment with the wildest battery idea you've ever heard, and hey, subscribe if you want to keep tabs on whether Germany actually pulls this off. Between now and 2030, that cost curve is going to bend even further. Automation will trim manufacturing overhead, better ceramics will push cycle life toward 50,000 hours, and here's a cool bit. Second life iron electrodes from scrapped units can be melted down and reused with almost no loss. Imagine that. Pair these long duration batteries with green hydrogen, another major German priority, and you suddenly have a fully renewable molecule and electron economy. The International Energy Agency already lists iron air as one of 5 technologies to watch. If deployment follows wind and solar's learning curve, we could see global installations hit 1 terawatt hour of capacity by 2035. At that point, talking about backup storage becomes completely obsolete. The storage is just part of the baseload. So, what does all this mean for you, personally? Lower battery costs translate directly to cheaper electricity. Analysts modeling the European market predict average wholesale prices could fall by 15% once iron air and cavern storage reach scale, saving a typical German household about 150 euros a year. Cleaner air follows naturally. Every gigawatt hour of coal displaced prevents roughly 1,000 tons of CO2. Over 25 years, a single iron air farm can avoid millions of tons of emissions, the equivalent of taking hundreds of thousands of cars off the road. And because these batteries are recyclable, the environmental win just keeps compounding. It's a win-win-win. So, can rust really keep the lights on? The German recipe, iron, salt, and a dash of oxygen, packs decades of durability, slashes costs, and sidesteps every critical mineral headache lithium creates. Add underground salt cavern storage for the truly long haul, and you have a 1-2 punch capable of carrying an industrial economy through weeks of gloomy skies. The pilots are funded, the patents are filed, and the first containers are under construction. If the engineers hit their numbers, the next time you flick on a light in Berlin at midnight, the electrons you summon might have spent the day as a humble pile of iron, quietly rusting its way into energy history.